Hello! In today's video, we are ranking WordGirl characters. I made three of them, so if you'd like to check them out, there are links to them in the description below. This first one is based on a post by Ink the Blob on Tumblr, and I will briefly explain what these categories are. So Blorbo is like my favorite, the one that I think about the most in the whole world. Skrunkly is, they're very cute, their design is like, I want to explode them. Scrimblow Bimblo is like my underappreciated fave. Amazo Guy, it was originally a different one, but I thought it would be funny to change it to Amazo Guy considering who I am. And this one's like your obscure fave. Poor Little Meow Meow are the controversial faves, the ones who are like pretty terrible, but they're your favorite anyway. Horse Plinko are the ones that I would torment for fun, or I just don't like them. EBDB is I would send them to super hell. This is like the worst one. So it's basically best to worst. So for the first one, it's WordGirl. I think she's a really awesome character. I think she's one of the best protagonists that I've seen on PBS. Like, I think she is really funny. Like, we're always rooting for her even when she makes bad choices. I think that's great. Gonna put Huggy in Scrimblow Bimblow just cause I do forget about him a lot, but when I think about both of them, I'm like, ah yes, a good character. Becky, I'm gonna put her in Blorbo. I think she's even funnier than WordGirl cause she doesn't have to put up a facade of being like a put together hero. She's just herself. Violet, I'm gonna put her in Skrunkly because she's so cute. She's one of the cutest characters in the whole show. Scoops, I'm gonna put him here because I think this might just be my bias because I really, really love the CW shows from the last decade. I think they're like so weird and funny. I think they could have done like a journalist superhero duo kind of thing like they have in the CW and all those like DC shows. I think that would have been really fun. And TJ, I'm gonna put him here. I think he's a fine character. I just don't like the annoying little brother trope, but it was popular in the early 2000s, so we're gonna let it slide, but it's still gonna go here. Tim and Sally are gonna go in Skrunkly because they're my second favorite pair of parents on TV, right after Chili and Bandit from Bluey. Eileen, gonna put her in Poor Little Meow Meow. Victoria, she's my favorite kid villain, and like out of all the villains, she's like top three favorite villains. I think her motives are always interesting, and I really like her character a lot. I think she makes really fun choices. Toby, I'm gonna put him here just because I think this is where he deserves to be for a little bit. He's gonna be put in Horse Plinko timeout. Miss McAllister, I'm gonna put her in Scrimblow Bimblo just because I really think they could have done like a, you know, like a Flint Lockwood's dad kind of thing. I really like character reactions. And so hers, if they were like more varied and consequential, I think that could have been really fun to see. These two, you'll already know. Pretty Princess.
She's so scrunkly, I love her.
Kid Math, The only reason he's going here is I feel like introducing a math character in a show for kids that like to read is just like, what are you doing here? Go to Cyber Chase, what are you doing here? The grocery store manager, he's very scrunkly to me. I like how he offers jobs to literally anybody he talks to. I think that's so funny. I love that continuous like joke. Reginald, definitely number one Horse Plinko. He's often the victim of like crimes, but I think he could suffer more. Exposition Guy, I'm gonna put him here. Poor Little Meow Meow. I think it's so funny, like I think about the time in the Miss Power episode, like WordGirl and Miss Power were talking about whatever, and he uses the most unpredictable mode of transportation to find them in the clouds. He uses a hot air balloon. And he finds them anyway. I think that's really funny. Bo Handsome. I'm gonna put him in Poor Little Meow Meow because he's kind of rude, but it's perfect because he puts those kids in their place whenever they step out of line so fast. Aw, it's Whittle Chuck. Gonna put him in Skrunkly. What a cute little guy. Brent, I'm also gonna put him in Skrunkly. They're very cute to me. I love them a lot. And we already know where she's going. Dr. Two Brains, we're gonna put him in Blorbo. I think he's the first Blorbo I've ever had in my life. Like I was like 7 years old and I was like, I don't know if I can be normal about this guy. We're gonna put Meatball and Charlie here. They're so cute. And for this one, I think, I know the fandom calls him Meatball, but I headcanon that his name is Ricky because he's like super rigid, like Ricky the name. And like, if you see his jumpsuit's kind of open, he has a little beanie, and he's like often the one that disobeys Dr. Two Brains. And then Charlie has like a very soft name because like his shoes and his jumpsuit and everything, he's very like put together and proper. And I think that's really cute of them, how this one's like Ricky, like rigid, and Charlie, it's cute. The Butcher. I think The Butcher is like behind Becky and Word Girl. I think he's the second best character to come out of this whole show. I love him so much. And yeah, I don't... This is just gonna end up being like terrible parents. Mr. Big and Leslie. They're like Team Rocket to me, except the stats and intelligence are very one-sided. So I'm gonna put them in Scrunkly. Next is Guy Rich. He will be tormented for fun in the Horse Plinko tier because his fake Southern accent was for a con and not for a bit. Hal Hardbargain. Putting him in Scrimblo Bimblo because his cons were bits and they were very funny. Granny May. Granny May's going here because she's very toxic and I love her for that. Gonna put Lady Redundant Woman in Poor Little Meow Meow. When I see her brooding and complaining about Dave and then talking to Dave with a smile and seemingly genuine appreciation and then right back to brooding, it's so funny. It makes me laugh because she hates this job so much that she'd turn to crime to get over it, but not enough that she'd be mean to Dave about it to his face. Gonna put Miss Question in Poor Little Meow Meow because I like seeing her ruin lives, and I think that's really funny considering who her voice actress is. It just sounds like she's having a blast ruining people's lives. I'm gonna put these two in Poor Little Meow Meow as well. We love some delinquents, some cute little delinquents. Maria! She's so scrunkly. Look, in this episode that I grabbed the screenshot from, I love how the helmet makes her look like she has a toddler, like a little toddler ponytail. So cute. Gonna put him here. Given everything about him, I think that's fair. On the topic of characters having fun ruining people's lives, I'm gonna put him here. Also, given everything about the Whammer, I think it's okay that we put him here. This is fair. Miss Power. Here on this channel, we support women's rights and women's wrongs. We're gonna put her up here at the Blorbo status. I think most of my love for Miss Power comes from my own personal headcanons, but honestly, I've loved this episode. This was such a great episode. Colonel Giggle Cheeks is going here for his personal crimes against me. His crime? Looking like a freak. I hate his design so much. I don't want to see him anymore. Squeaky Box Lightner is going to the Horse Plinko category. Solely for being mean to these two that one time. Also, I was thinking about how the definition of having a biological child means that the child carries the parent's DNA. So in this case, I'd have to argue that Squeaky Boxlightner is the biological and adopted son of Steven Boxlightner. Next up is Steven Boxlightner. Hahaha, I'm so normal about this character. He only has 2 minutes of screen time, so there's not much to think or say about him. He's going in the Amazo Guy category. First resident of the Amazo Guy category. Yay. Next is Amazo Guy. Now we have to choose carefully where he goes. Give it a lot of thought and consideration. This feels right. For those of you unfamiliar with Amazo, he is on the cover of this book and forever lives in my mind. You may be wondering, did you just make all this stuff up about him? Why would I lie on the internet? I truly believe everything I've made up about him, and that's not lying. That's just being delusional. Next is Chris Parnell. He's very scrunkly to me. Also, do you like how I used his actual picture? There's no... I was thinking about if I should just picture the sky, but I think it's so funny to just see his face among everybody else. That's the narrator. And finally, Sherry Bomb. For those of you who don't know, she's actually canon. I'm just goofing. She's my Word Girl villain OC. Sherry owns a bakery in Fair City and runs her business most of the time. When an interesting and hard to get ingredient enters Fair City, she goes after it with her homemade explosive cupcakes, each flavor doing something different, like powdered sugar smoke bombs or quick drying frosting, all that fun stuff. I love her with my entire heart, so she is going to beat, she is gonna beat Two Brains in this. She's my ultimate Blorbo. And honestly, these two would beat everybody in the Blorbo category, but I have this category, so I gotta put these two there. Also, do you guys like how he's second? So yeah, that's this one. And again, if you wanna do this one with your friends or whatever, there's gonna be links to this. So the next one is Word Girl Characters Ranked Violence Edition. Kills or be killed, babes. So for this one is not based on anything. This is just me saying like everyone's physical stats. So this one, it's basically like I would win versus I would die. So the first one is I'm sending them to Word Girl Hell, which is like, I'm not a violent person and I wouldn't try to end anyone. But this one is I hate them so much. There is a will and a way. They are not staying here. The next one is I would send them to the hospital. This is where I'm pretty strong. I could do some damage. This one is we bonk heads and fall down. This one is our strength is evenly matched. So we just bonk heads and fall down like baby kittens. I cry and forfeit the fight. This is where I look at them and I'm like, I can't go to sleep at night knowing that I tried to fight you. So I cry and I just call it. The next one is I get bruised in the shape of their character logo. All of these characters have like personal motifs that appear when they do things, when the animators feel like putting their motifs on things. So that motif that will appear on my body as my bruise shape. And the last one, they would send me to God. I would die. I am no longer here. So let's get started. So the first one is Word Girl. I think we all know. I don't stand a chance with Huggy either. You cannot underestimate monkeys. I could not possibly fight mild-mannered fifth grader Becky Botsford. I cry and forfeit the fight. Same with Violet. I couldn't look at them. Actually, I'm gonna put all these kids here. I can't do it. Look at them. They're so little. They're just fifth graders in undisclosed grade. I think Sally and Tim would send me to the hospital. They would bruise me in the shape of the justice scale and a grill spatula thing. They would tag team it too. I feel like it's one of those obscure skills that they both have. Eileen, I would cry. Look at her little face. But actually, yeah. Actually, I changed my mind. If I were a civilian in Fair City, I would think that Bob is a dog because apparently every single Fair City citizen struggles with animal recognition. So I would cry. Why would I kick a dog? Toby, he would just cheat. He would send one of the robots and I would instantly meet my maker. Victoria, I'm also gonna put here. Actually, I'm gonna put Victoria here. I feel like she has a lot of martial arts training as well, with like all her trophies and stuff. That's like a classic rich kid thing to get good at. Miss McAllister, I do not stand a chance. This lady, 8 feet tall, 9 feet tall, 15 feet tall. I don't stand a chance. The bests, I would find a way. Pretty Princess. Pretty Princess and I would agree to wrestle, but as we're both beautiful and pink themed, we're evenly matched and we bonk heads. I feel like this would be an accident, but Kid Math would just throw me into the sun. The grocery store manager, I think he used to be a villain, so I don't think he has a problem with violence. Reginald, I don't hate this guy. I do dislike him. So I think, I would send him to the hospital. For exposition guy, I think initially I could send him to the hospital, but he just like cosmically cannot be harmed. Like he will find a way to get rid of the threat. So I think we bonk heads and fall down because of that. I think Bo Handsome would initially have the upper hand, but then he would say something to piss me off and I would just send him to the hospital. All Chuckles would have to do is say something like, yeah, and I would start cry laughing and I would forfeit the fight. Brett seems very fit and I'm sure he could land a couple of blows, leaving me with sandwich shaped bruises. Crustless, of course. I am finding a way. These people are not gonna be here for much longer. There's a will, there's a way. Dr. Two Brains is canonically very weak, and I headcanon that he hired his henchmen to carry anything that weighs more than 3 pounds. So I would just watch some jujitsu videos on YouTube like 5 minutes before the fight to compensate for his stark height, and I'd be fine. There we go. Meatball seems like he grew up in Brooklyn, so yeah, I'm getting some bruises. Charlie would simply look at me with his gentle eyes, and I would run away crying. It's Da Butcher. I feel like he would have no issue burying me in a hamalanche. He is following the rest of the dysfunctional parents. Mr. Big looks very buff, but I think our motor skills are very evenly matched. So I think we bonk heads and fall down. Leslie knows martial arts. I'm not making it out of here without some bruises in the shape of clipboards. Guy Rich doesn't stand a chance against me and my dislike of wealth flaunting. But it's okay when Mr. Big does it because he's so dumb about it. Hal Hardbargain would send me to God and have no issue with that. And then afterwards he would work on a fun little ray to chillax. If Granny May had her mecha suit on, I would die. But if not, I think she knows enough that I'm gonna leave with some bruises. Lady Redundant Woman would talk about how she could take me on, but ultimately we would bonk heads due to her tendency to bottle up her emotions. Miss Question and I would bonk heads because she tried to convince me with her questioning zap thing, and I just lose my balance. I think these two would accidentally bonk heads with each other, and then with me bringing us all down. Maria would cook me and send me to God, well done. I mean, you've seen his sword, his muscles, his lack of boundaries. I don't stand a chance. I think Seymour Orlando Smooth would try to blind me with his teeth, but I would still charge like a bull and we bonk heads. The Whammer would send me to God. Easy. Miss Power is the only character who has almost sent another character to meet their maker, and I don't think I'd be any different. I'm gonna put her actually up here. Most likely to do this. I know what I said about monkeys before, but Colonel Giggle Cheeks is going here. I do not want to see him. Squeaky Box Lightner is so little, so small. You can fit so much evil in this bad boy. I think I would put him here because I would also think that this is a dog if I were a Fair City citizen. Steven Box Lightner is the kind of guy to die in a terrible accident in his own lab by the hand of his own machine and Mousy. So, we bonk heads. A headcanon Amazo guy to have very similar powers to WordGirl and Miss Power, so there's no chance I'm making it out alive. But he would feel a little bad afterward. The narrator would just drop a light fixture on my head, killing me instantly. Sherry Bomb was a chemistry student of Steven Boxlighter and has the same curious nature, so I don't think I'm making it out of here alive, or at least with all of my organs intact. See, yeah, that's the Viowolence Addition. And for this one, there's another link. This is gonna be the second link. And the last one. For this last one, we're gonna be ranking WordGirl characters hot to Uggo. So it's just the adult ones, obviously. Ugliest to most foul. So for this, the first one is, I'm confessing my undying love with roses, pasta, and a diamond ring. The next one is, I have their Starbucks order memorized. They are a stock photo to me. I'm completing their heart hand with a thumbs up. And then the last one, I would hit him with my car, back up, and then hit him again. And I'm not gonna explain these verbally. I'm just gonna elaborate telepathically. So let me know your thoughts as well. Preferably telepathically as well, but a comment works too. Sally, of course. Tim, Miss McAllister. She doesn't have enough screen time for me to know her well enough, which is the dumbest excuse considering who I am, but that's my excuse anyway. Obviously. Stock photo to me. He is a stock photo. I feel like he radiates this. The picture that I'm showing, this is him. Bo handsome. He's a handsome guy. What can I say? Chuck is just cute enough for me to know his Starbucks order. Brent? Brent the handsome, successful, everyone loves him sandwich making guy? A dreamboat. Obviously. And I use a different picture for this. I think this one works very well. I think Two Brains is only in this category, theoretically, but in practice, I'm running him over with my car. What can I say? I like his off-putting swag and his willingness to steal the moon. Starbucks, also Starbucks. Car, Mr. Big. This one is more literal. This one, I hope you guys understand that this isn't for love, but it's because I want a trampoline, but the one that I want is like $1,000, so he's gonna pay for it. What a pretty lady. Of course. This one would be kind of funny, actually. This one as well. I know her order. I feel like Lady Redundant Woman would order the vanilla bean frappuccino just because I feel like that's the most redundant one. Same with Miss Question. I think they're both going to Starbucks and getting those cute little drinks. These two are stock photos to me. No Can, Seymour, Whammer, Miss Power. I'm gonna rearrange these a little bit. He's at the end because he's not supposed to be here. I just need his money for the trampoline. I think this is a good order. Yes. Okay, and then Steven Boxlightner. Gotta love a guy that does a little evil laugh after doing something relatively harmless. Amazo guy, just based on my completely fabricated headcanons. He's very cute. Narrator, aka Chris Parnell. Sherry, she's a cute little lady. So yeah, that is the three lists that I have. And this is my account if you find them. These are the titles. You'll have the links, it'll be fine. And thank you for watching. And feel free to tell me what you think in the comments. I will actually read it. This is one of those goofy videos that I think I want to hear you guys' most chaotic takes, basically. And once again, thank you to these lovely supporters over on Ko-fi. If you'd like to be credited in future videos, consider supporting for just $1 each month. So for this fandom video, I am putting out some stickers, and these stickers, like in the last ones, are gonna be available forever, but for the next 2 weeks, there's gonna be a skateboard and a camera sticker included for free with your order, but after that, you can still get it for like $1 there, it's fine. These little TBH yippies, I think they're so cute and funny. I really like making scenes with them in the WordGirl Discord server. So yeah, thanks for watching, and I hope if you get some stickers, you enjoy them. Okay, love you, bye.